Hey guys, what is going on? It is your boy. We are back with some more WWE, and we are in Raw. I have a great card for you guys right about now. I hope you guys enjoy it, because I brought back some legends, and you guys will love it. But anyway, you guys know I'm not going to be on mic that much because I want them to do the commentary, but I will come in with my own commentary. And as you guys can see, I'm just going to show you guys the match. This is another tribute to Scott Hall, but this is not going to be the only one. And we got a Bret Hart versus Jerry the King Lawler. Haven't seen Lawler since his heart attack, but I think he's still alive, but he's retired. Then we got Rebecca, we have my creative character Rebecca, who ended 2K20 with the Women's Championship, but I'm gonna have them work their way up. Then, we got these guys, and then that, and my character at the end to face Seth Rollins. As you know, I beat him for the championship in the 2K20 at the end at WrestleMania. But was it WrestleMania or was it Elimination Chamber? No, it was WrestleMania. And so let's go ahead and get into it, guys. We ain't gonna be here too long today, but I don't know, with these tag team matches, the way they've been going, they've been giving me a run for the money. All right, guys, I'm going to get off so you guys can hear it all.
Targeting a body part, working the arm. catcher. Back to the punch of the gut. There's some power behind that punch. Big E is obviously known for his size and power, but he's also surprisingly agile. Corey, what do you think is Big E's best bet here? To rely on the expected, that size and power, or to perhaps focus on that surprising speed?
Well, at the end of the day, Cole, Big E can slow down like anyone else, but his power will never leave him. I think it's pretty obvious what he wants to do. Rely on the power.
Looking for more damage here. Release back suplex.
Ouch. Oh, a nasty stomp to finish it off.
And it's reverse pain for that mistake. Catches the kick. Belly to belly.
Oh, that was impressive.
Oh, drop. And Jeff is being knocked around. Big E's relying on that power. It's giving him the advantage right now.
Big E able to avoid impact.
Just breaking down the opponent.
Big E on the move.
Oh, incredible elevation. Shoulders down.
That would have been three.
Has his opponent up. This is about to go over. Because here
comes two. Does that finish Hardy off? Is it enough? The cover. It's enough. Oh, that's nice work.
Here is your winner, Big E.
What a fast victory, guys. No contest.
An absolute statement by the victor here tonight. What a steamroller.
All right, guys, sorry about that. I had to take care of something, but I'm back. I didn't even get the chance to see the match because I had something to do. That, I don't know, it might have been fast. I might have to go back and catch it. But we got somebody we ain't seen in the WWE since the early 90s, and it was Papa Shango. I was surprised they actually put him in the game, so I'm just like, wow. I was really shocked. So let's see what Papa Shango has going on, because I ain't seen him for, and I forgot who Papa Shango was, but I think he died too. So let's see.
It's Hall and Nash. And their opponents, at a combined weight of 608 pounds, Kevin Nash and Scott Hall, the Outsiders.
Two of the most intimidating men of all time. Grabbing headlines. Changing the way the game is played. And if you don't like it, learn to love it.
They don't have music. Now, see, that's a ripoff.
This is a situation that can be bad news for the superstar in a handicap position. The risk of injury becomes heightened because there's always an opponent capable of being on your back. There's no respite for the body as it endures relentless punishment. And for some, it is used as an opportunity to toss the rule book out the window because one side is outnumbered. Oh, a shot right to the kidney. And again.
Guys,
here,
I'm mad at that. They did not give them no music. Really? That's bull crap. I'm mad with that. But I did look up Papa Shango, and I forgot it was the Godfather, the wrestler. He's still alive. I thought he was dead, but he's still alive, thank goodness. But, you know, I actually like the Godfather. You know, he was from the Red Light District and all that good stuff. So, yeah, I really like Godfather. But, you know, we ain't heard anything. I guess he just said he wanted to be out the limelight, so I don't blame him. But I'm mad with that. They didn't give them to no music. I don't know what to say about that.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall on the way to the ring, accompanied by Marines at a combined weight of 436 pounds. The Miz and John Morrison.
Miz and Morrison will go to any lengths to capture a victory. Relentless offensive onslaught between the two of them. Byron Saxton's got to go.
Yeah, I don't know what to say about these guys. Arrogant and obnoxious, but I still like them. Especially Maurice. Oh my goodness. Her arrogance is just on another level.
Tag team match here with The Miz and John Morrison. Then across from them we see T-Bar and Mace.
These teams have built up lots of animosity towards each other, and now they have finally reached a tipping point. I would expect Bedlam to break loose here.
For the tag.
Cross right to the throat. Man can't breathe, the man can't fight. Using the elbow as a weapon.
Really just laying it in.
Mace setting himself up to He's got to know he's in harm's way here. From way up, down. Morris inside, coming.
Standing Spanish fly, are you kidding me?
Incredible. And there's the tag, the miss into the ring. Straight to the floor. Man can't breathe, the man can't breathe. Chuck slam, tossed him across the ring. Tag made. Oh, targeting the stomach. Into the corner now. Oh, targeting the arm, this has got to hurt. Partner. Punch right in the head. Oh, he's got him here. He's got him. And whatever's playing here can't be good. Getting tossed around. He's lost some of his wind now.
Start counting, Saxton.
One, two, three.
He could be here all day.
Power.
I think you're right.
Here's the ball.
Oh, a kick out. He is certainly sending a message, getting his shoulder up before two.
Ooh, slam.
With authority.
Trying to stay a step ahead.
Side Russian leg sweep.
He could pass opponent right here.
It's over. He's able to beat a two count.
Kicking out now sends a very clear message.
Oh, what a leg sweep. Put it in the corner.
Yeah, they stuck it out through this match, but it wouldn't hurt to go for the tag soon here.
Suplex, here it comes.
turns.
Tag. Opponent off the ropes.
Hard impact on the back. The stomp in every single part of his body. You hear that? Look at the tape. There's no escape from the King of Club. And there's the save.
It might just take that extra push, that extra inch further to create the difference.
There he goes, right into the corner.
Big kick connects. Morrison looking to end this thing. This will do it.
And sizing him up from the top.
Oh, man!
Tag made. Tag made. Oh, slam!
With authority.
Go right to the kidneys.
Ah,
shot to the back. He's expressing pain now.
Impressive offense from the Miz. These superstars are throwing away endlessly, and this crowd is on their feet in full appreciation. An incredible sight to see.
Bad predicament right here.
Down across the knee. That won't just separate your shoulder. That'll divorce it. We'll slide back in the ring now.
Systematic attack on that shoulder. And there's the tag.
The Miz into the ring.
Kick by the Miz.
Something in the corner.
In full control here.
Face full of turnbuckle. Oh, right to the body. Vicious shoulder attack in the corner.
The Miz has seen better days.
Boom! Oh, shot breaking up.
T-Bar
holds the
up.
T-Bar may have put the exclamation on this one.
Cover! Coming to the rescue. He's ejected from the ring.
He's not going to be able to pull this off, is he?
Oh.
Is he?
Yeah! In this match.
Side headlock applied.
Out of the ropes and back into the ring.
Two.
Just punched him right in the mouth. Relentless.
Enough already.
Stomping down. My goodness, did you hear that shot?
Off the tag.
Miz with the snapmare. Miz hit the ropes. Big boot. Does he have it here?
1, 2, 3.
And he makes the save for his team.
Arrogant and obnoxious, but they still are good, guys. I don't know what to say. I think I'm gonna have a team to come in and, you know, and face them to knock the arrogance out of them. I mean, it was almost, they almost did. They almost made it look good. But this is another classic. I think we only got like 3 matches with these two throughout their whole time in the WWE. And Lawler hated Bret. I don't know why. He could not stand Bret, but I'm going to have a lot of rivalry matches with these two. And Bret Hart was my very first WWE superstar. I mean, I'm a stan for Bret. I'm a Bret stan. I'm not a fan. I'm a stan. Man, but I am a Shawn Michaels fan. But when they fought at WrestleMania 12, oh my God. I was split down the middle for both of them. I was like, oh my God. But it still came out to be the best match ever. And that catapulted Shawn to stardom, that matchup. The Iron Man match, the very first one, man, that catapulted Shawn to stardom to like no other. Man. And that put him and Brett back into the Hall of Fame, though. Boom!
From Memphis, Tennessee.
Nobody cares.
Wave at the king.
The king wish not acknowledge your petty existence, Saxton. Byron, you would not be allowed anywhere near the castle.
I think I have some royal attributes.
Dozens of championships won in Memphis before he joined WWE. One of the all-time greats.
Hey, King!
The flying fist drop. It was actually an honor of mine, Corey, to be able to have been hit in the mouth by the flying fist drop at one point in my career.
Well, the King looks ready to deliver a royal beating. Maybe to you again, Michael.
Maybe to Cole, but King won't let you near his crown, Saxton.
Aw, man.
Tonight, Bret Hart has his sights set on his opposition, and the Hitman looks ready. The sharpest shooter in WWE looks locked and loaded for this showdown. When the excellence of execution is focused like this, it spells trouble for his opponent. And standing across the ring is a bona fide legend of Memphis, Tennessee, Jerry the King Lawler, one of the craftiest veterans this business has ever produced.
Yeah, don't let the commentary career fool you. Lawler ruled the territories back in the day. He knows how to mix it up, knows how to play dirty, and doesn't have a problem doing it.
Isolating the arm.
Up the chest and now straight to the knee.
Punch connects. He got whipped into that corner.
Hold on!
Corey, Bret Hart is an expert at controlling the tempo of a match. He can go move for move with anyone, but what does he need to do to leave victorious here tonight?
As a five-star general in that ring, Cole, Hart must do what he does best. Bring his opponent down to the mat, keep a deliberate, calculated pace, and dissect his adversary.
If y'all know, Lawler used to cheat so much in his matches when it came to Bret. y'all all, everybody know how bad Lawler used to cheat. I'm like, oh my god. And this right here, this never happened. That never happened. They can't stand each other. Now that I can see the rivalry being high, but them shaking hands, if y'all seen them, y'all know good damn well. Brett never, and not even Lawler. I don't know why they would even do that. I don't know. I can't tell y'all. I have no clue. But we'll see. We will see. Now it's time for my girl, Rebecca, to make her, you know, return to the WWE. She was gone last time, but she's back this week. Why y'all booing her? Oh, I think I got it mixed. She looks so much better than she did on the other, on 2K20. She's more ripped. She's buffer. I couldn't find the outfit that I had for her, but I gave her something different. I gave her something different, so I'm liking it. I am loving it. But yes, her and Rhea Ripley, they have a beef from 2K20. Y'all didn't see it. It was in my career. My Rise. That was the name of it. And they had a humongous beef that I never played out. But now it's going to play out at Nelson. All right, I'm going to hush and I'm going to play. But y'all, I'm going to be here at the end with some more commentary.
Is at an all-time high here as these two settle things in a no-holds-barred match.
No move is illegal. No object is off-limits. This is going to be brutal. And I, for one, cannot wait.
Hands off, she wrote.
They changed that on me. We doing a rematch. We doing a rematch. Because that, no. They changed that up on me.
One-on-one match with no rules, no rules.
I didn't even know they changed the pinning because the way they had the pin.
She probably didn't expect it to put her away there, but she's put her on notice.
There's a snapmare.
Now this is more like it. This is where I was.
But it does provide an opening to be creative in your offense. So
creative.
Forearm to the face.
Oh, nothing fancy about that. Oh, straight forearm.
There we go.
My goodness.
Climbing to the top rope.
Taking fire.
Set something else up. Discouraging results for Ripley right here.
Ripley needs to be resourceful. Find an opening.
And a count. Two. Kick out close to three.
She is still fighting, still keeping this going.
Coast to coast. He's gonna kick the features off their face. She shoots up the top rope. Dig on the top. Diving double axe handle.
Ripley is down, and she might be out.
Ripley left an opening.
Guys, I don't know what happened. I thought it was the Undertaker gonna come out and... What happened? Yeah, I don't know what just happened. That had to be a glitch. I cannot, for the life of me, figure out what the heck just happened with that. But just know it was not me, my friends. It was not me. I thought it was the Undertaker about to come in because y'all know he does that. But that, I don't know what happened. I really, really don't. But she still won, regardless of it being in the dark. She still won, so.
The most lethal superstar in the history of WWE, the Apex Predator. The following contest is a triple threat tornado tag team match. Introducing first, representing RK-Bro from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 250 pounds, one half of the Raw Tag Team Champions, the Viper.
Superstar than Randy Orton.
It's a superstar who will do whatever it takes to win. Hey, listen, he's called the Apex Predator because he has this undeniable killer instinct. And the results, well, they speak for themselves.
Yeah, simple advice. Don't cross the Viper.
Stallion
216 pounds, one half of the Raw Tag Team Champions, Riddle.
Riddle's also somehow one of the most relaxed guys in the business outside the ring. All business inside of it.
I like Riddle. I like his swag. I think I can learn a thing or two from him.
It's not going to make you any cooler.
Hey guys, I am back. Look, I told you.
At a combined weight of 453 pounds, Dolph Ziggler and Bobby Roode, Dirty Dogs.
The moment this match was announced, the WWE Universe has expected a classic. I think it is destined to deliver. Team tornado match underway. Multiple teams facing off, but there will only be one winner.
Everyone competing at once. She's really the status of your partner, and every opponent in this match.
Front face lock applied. It's about to get more painful. Boom! Right in the
target.
Swinging neckbreaker. position. Stops the kick.
Was mounted to the punches. Oh, nasty stop to finish it off.
He's absorbing some tough hits. Careful, stop putting it on. And senton. Vicious. And Senton. Is it enough for zero? Referee breaks the count. Looks like a rope break.
I don't even want to know. Okay, I don't have much time, so I'm going to simulate this matchup right here. We'll make Rey Mysterio win this one. Okay. Let me see. Brock Lesnar. Yeah, I'll go ahead and play this one. Let this play out. Because I don't have much time. I'm on a time constraint. So, I'm trying to make sure that, you know, I don't run over to 8 o'clock. I got something to do at 8. If this runs like between 7:45, I'm going to... Now, Brock, you should know I'm coming for it. Brock, you should know I'm coming. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go on the community creations. I'm gonna see if they got the Undisputed Championship in red. So, like, when my character, when he does win the title, I can put it. I can have him wear the red one. I gotta remember who's the Universal Champion here. Because we going at the Roman Reigns, and it's Bluetooth. I'm liking it. So, I'm gonna go in there and see, so that way when I win the title, I can switch it up. But what I do like about it, if you guys didn't watch SmackDown, my custom created character came out with the championship from, it was from one of the custom, community creations. And I did not, because normally they would not let you wear those in, Universal, WWE Universe. I was shocked that he came out with it. I gave it to him, but normally you would wear it when you're just like playing, just playing one-on-one, you know, like that. But I'm glad they incorporated those. It makes it that much more, engaging. Because these people have made all these custom-made belts and stuff, and you can't even use them. I'm just saying. It don't make sense to, you know, make all this stuff and you can't use them. So... And then that would give me some, that would give some better matches for Clash of the Champions. Because I'm going to bring that back. I'm bringing Clash of the Champions back. So we can have a lot of title matches. Oh my God. Clash of the Champions is going to be off the chain. There's going to be so many champions, it ain't even fun. I'm going to have to pick between, it's going to be some big matches between SmackDown, Raw, and NXT. And I usually don't do NXT, but I'm going to do it this time. All right, guys. I'm signing out. But he's got his work cut out for him tonight. Kevin Owens is seriously one tough customer. A prize fighter always ready for a fight. That's the truth. No matter the time or the place, Kevin Owens is always prepared and maybe even a little excited to climb in the ring and trade blows. Ah, what a smash! That is just insulting.
Lesnar unleashed. The arm bar is locked in.
Oh, man. Quick as a cat, just like that. That was a thing of beauty. Perhaps thinking about what to do next here. He heads outside. Countouts legal in this match. Fighting the beast back.
Trying to talk at the back of the neck here.
He slides back into the ring.
Six.
And he's taking this to the outside now. Lesnar from behind.
Brock Lesnar perhaps setting up for a trifecta of Germans here. And Cody, you know what this means?
An all expenses paid trip.
Rock's holding nothing back. A ferocious attack with no regard for his opponent.
You said it, Savage. Put a stop to that.
He may get the three count right here.
Two. Both competitors digging deep into their well to keep this match going.
Matchup of the night, and when I come back for SmackDown, we're gonna have some good matches going on and all that good stuff. So let's go ahead and get it. Like I said, there's gonna be some good stuff coming, guys. I'm just letting y'all know. Hold on, I have no idea. Man. Awesome. I forgot to change his shirt back to black. I'm gonna have to do that. Let's see. Guys, I really don't have a lot to say on this, but I'm going to dip out.
Making his way to the ring from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing in at 265 pounds, Angel Smith.
The tension building for this match is so thick you can cut it with a knife. A lot of drama involved with this one.
Seth Rollins has unmasked accolades, a championship resume, but a wardrobe that leaves a lot to be desired.
Saxton, last time you saw that much drip, you call him plumber.
And his opponent from Davenport, Iowa, weighing in at 217 pounds, Seth Rollins!
So he's been called the King Slayer, right? The architect, the Messiah. How about we give him a new nickname, Mr. Delusional?
bite your tongue, Cole. There's nothing delusional about this man. Seth Rollins has earned everything. It just happens that everyone else is jealous.
Multiple Universal and WWE title reigns. He's won the Royal Rumble and Money in the Bank.
You know, there was a time when Seth Rollins used to feed off the energy of the WWE Universe. Now he's just happy celebrating all of his accomplishments alone.
When it comes to Seth Rollins, I think the fact that he anointed himself the Messiah really says it all.
Yeah, Seth believes that he is the salvation of the WWE, that the WWE Universe should follow him blindly and hang on his every word. But while he calls himself the Messiah, others call him a megalomaniac.
Oh, call him what you want. There's no denying that Rollins has asserted his dominance now out of the ring. Anyone who doesn't convert to his cause gets punished.
Yeah, but meeting him in the ring is quite an obstacle. There's nothing about this superstar that signifies he'll be a pushover.
Oh, what a nasty knee lift. He's lost some of his win now. There's a big reversal by Seth Rollins. Corey, there's plenty of things you can say about what makes Seth Rollins an exceptional superstar. But what stands out to you in this match? For me, his shoulders are down. Raises the shoulder before the one count.
This isn't even close to over. He's getting a huge boost right now from all those chants and cheers.
Saving us from having to sit through that.
Lands face first. launching. Oh, taking a chance one more time and landing with incredible impact.
Oh, knee lift.
Somebody better check his nose.
Seth Rollins just getting dismantled.
This can't be how Rollins envisioned his night going.
What a savage display of power by
Hunter here!
Kick it out before the count.
Right now, I just don't know what it's going to take.
He's able to sidestep there.
Oh, sharp knee.
Rollins struggling. Wow.
I'm going to show him how to use my Dane Blast technique against me.
Here is your winner, Angel Smith.
You don't use my technique against me and think you're going to get away with it. No. And I'm like, he pedigreed me, y'all. I cannot believe that, that bastard. But that's why his ass laying on the damn ground and I'm here. All right, guys. I'm going to sign out. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to come back and see your boy. I love you all, and I will see you guys later.